Hi, I am Sridhar Gubala. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today, in this video, we're gonna see what is transactions in Adobe Premiere Pro. So, let's get started. Now, I will open my Adobe Premiere Pro. So, this is the main screen. This is a wallpaper of the Adobe Premiere Pro. So my Adobe Premiere Pro is opened. So I will create a new project, naming as Demo 2, and press OK. So the main screen of Adobe Premiere Pro is opened. So I will import two videos without audio. I will go to Media Browser, and I will select two clips and press open. The files have been imported, so I will import from Media Browser to timeline. So yeah, two videos has been included. So but actually I want without video, so I will select two video clips. So I've imported only two videos, not audio. So transaction, what is transaction? For example, I will show you if I will play this video. Yeah, from here I will show you. As you see, as you saw, after the first clip, the video or the bar has shifted to second clip. The gap between these two videos is called as transactions. In Adobe Premiere Pro, there are lots of transactions included. So I will show you how to add transactions. So I will show you how to add transactions. First of all, as you can see, there is a gap between these two clips. So I will right click on the mouse. As you can see, there are there is option called apply default transactions. I will click on that. Wait a minute. So yeah, the default transaction has been applied in Adobe in this video called cross dissolve. Cross dissolve is a basic cross dissolve is a default transactions which Premiere Pro gives you from starting. If I play this clip, wait a minute, I will okay, as you can see, this is transaction applied in this clip. So if I take this here, I will show you. As you can see, there is a transactions applied, transition applied between these two clips. Show you. As you can see, this is a transaction which is applied by Adobe Premiere for default by clicking right click and apply the default transaction. As the transaction is applied, there is option called set transaction duration. I will show you later what is that. If you want to increase or decrease a transaction, what will you do is, so to increase the transaction, so as you can see, there is a box coming here. So if I increase the duration of it, as you can see, the duration of transaction is increased. But I usually say that keep the transaction as small as possible, as fast as possible. So I will decrease this transaction speed. Yeah, I've decreases the transaction speed. I will show you how to change transaction in different way, the duration of transaction in different way. So yeah, I will show you the different way to increase or decrease the transaction duration. Go to editing section and you will see the effects control panel. There is an option, as you can see here, this is a transaction we applied in the video. If you want to increase it, you can increase the transaction like this way. or I'm increasing, as you can see this is duration of the transaction is increasing. So there are lots of transactions given by Adobe Premiere Pro. Go to effects panel. In effects panel there is called video transaction and video effects. Go in video transactions. As you can see, there are lots of transactions available in Adobe Premiere Pro: 3D motion, dissolve, immerse video, erase, page peel, etc. So if I want to remove this cross dissolve, I will right click on the mouse cursor and press clear. So the default transaction applied in this video will be removed. So if I want to add immerse video, if I want to add dissolve, I will click on dip to black and add in this video. As you can see, dip to black transaction is applied. So I will show you how it decrease the size of timeline. So yeah, and I will play this video. As you can see there is a black screen. This is a transaction which we applied. As you can see, the other part of the video is continuing. So this is called transactions. There are lots of transactions. For example, I will remove dip to black and click on this and clear. If I add film dissolve, I'll add film dissolve. Okay, and I will go back. I'll press button. As you can see, the some transaction is applied in this video. If I want to add another transaction, I will show you. Mop cut. I will add mop cut and it will take time, so I will add another non-electric dissolve. I will add this clip. Yeah, as you can see, this is a transaction, non-adaptive dissolve. So there are lots of transactions in Adobe Premiere Pro. So immersive video, erase, page peel. So you can add any transaction you want. But keep less transactions in your video, and add more effects, video effects, sound effects in your video. I try to keep less video transactions and more video effects. In next video, I will tell the same what is video effects. Actually, video effects is also called transactions, but not purely transactions. So I will explain it in another video. There are lots of transactions if you want to add. In sound, if you want to add transaction, there are sound effects for sound, for audio. If you want to make your video cinematic, if you are showing any story, then add page peel or dip to black transactions. So yeah, for this video we will stop here. I will see you in the next video. So if you like this video, press like button and please do subscribe my channel. Press bell button for my upcoming notification when I will upload my new video. So stay safe and thank you.